Hello students, welcome to EduFarm. Believe and become classes for GPAT and NIPER JEE. Like and share the video and subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell icon to never miss any update. Hello students, here we have a compilation of all the test yourself question only for your convenience. 100 question from test yourself is only for 100 rupees, all in a PDF format. You just need to contact us through the mail, and the mail address is eduform1994@gmail.com. Contact now to avail this offer. Also, we are coming up with a question set for NIPER JEE, and for that, stay tuned with EduFarm. Welcome again in another lecture by EduFarm. Today's lecture is the continuation of absorption of drugs. This is the second part of the video. In this video, we will discuss about the factors affecting drug absorption. So, let's begin. The biological response to a drug is the result of an interaction between the drug substance and functionally important molecule, that is the receptors in living system. The response is due to an alteration in the biological process that were present prior to the administration of drug. To achieve the desired therapeutic effect, the drug product must deliver the active drug at an optimal rate and amount. The rate and extent of drug absorption or the systemic delivery of drug to the body can be varied from rapid and complete absorption to slow and sustained absorption depending upon the desired therapeutic effect. In a broad sense, the factors that influence drug absorption and thus the efficacy of drug can be divided into two categories. One is pharmaceutical factors and another is patient related factor. Pharmaceutical factors can be further subdivided into physicochemical properties of drug substance and the dosage form characteristics and pharmaceutical ingredients. In this lecture, we will discuss about the pharmaceutical factors only. Rest of the factor will be discussed later, and for that, stay tuned with EduFarm. Here is one factor, that is drug solubility and dissolution rate. Consider the events that occur following oral administration of a solid dosage form. After administration of a solid dosage form, drug gets disintegrated to drug particles, which is then reached in the absorption site into the solution form by dissolution and finally permeation through the gastrointestinal barrier reached into the bloodstream. Here, dissolution and permeation are two slower rate determining steps. Dissolution is the rate limiting step for lipophilic drug, and permeation is the rate limiting steps for hydrophilic drugs. So, on dissolution, as the dissolution is the controlling step in the overall process, absorption is said to be the dissolution rate limited. Any factor that influence the dissolution rate must also interfere the rate of absorption, and for the absorption of a drug, it must be present in the aqueous solution, and this is depends on aqueous solubility of drug and dissolution rate. Further discussion regarding the dissolution will be discussed later. For now, let's move on to the next factor, that is particle size and effective surface area. Dissolution rate is directly proportional to the effective surface area, and smaller the particle size, greater is the effective surface area. More intimate contact between solid surface and aqueous solvent, higher is the dissolution rate and increase in absorption efficiency. One example is poorly aqueous soluble non-hydrophobic drugs like Grisoflavin, Chloramphenicol, whose dissolution is rate limited. Particle size effects are of particular consequence when slowly dissolving drugs are considered. Particle size reduction usually result in more rapid and complete absorption. Next factor is polymorphism and amorphism. The variation in the arrangement of molecules or ions to form a crystal is referred to as polymorphism. Polymorphs that have no crystal structure or amorphic forms have different physical properties from the crystalline one. These polymorphs have different physical properties such as dissolution rate and solubility. One example is the vitamin riboflavin, which exists in several polymorphic forms, and these have a 20-fold range in aqueous solubility. Amorphous form generally have greater aqueous solubility than crystalline forms, as no energy is needed to break up the crystal lattice. For this reason, amorphous form is preferred over crystalline one, and several drugs, that is hydrocortisone, prednisolone, are marketed in the amorphic form. Now, the pseudopolymorphism. Many drugs can associate with solvents to produce crystalline form, which is called solvates. Solvates can exist in different crystalline forms called pseudopolymorphs, and this phenomenon is known as pseudopolymorphism. Water is the most common solvate. If water molecules are already present in a crystal structure, the tendency of the crystal to attract additional water to initiate the dissolution process is reduced, and solvated crystals tend to dissolve more slowly than anhydrous forms. Solvates have a greater solubility than their non-solvents. Example is chloroform solvates of Grisoflavin and N-pentanol solvate of fluorocortisone. The next factor is salt form of a drug. Whether acidic or basic, at a given pH, the solubility of drug or its salt is constant. While considering the salt form of a drug, pH of the diffusion layer is important, not the pH of the bulk of the solution. Here is an example. You can see salt of weak acid, which increases the pH of the diffusion layer, which promotes the solubility and dissolution of a weak acid, and absorption is bound to be rapid. Another approach to enhance the dissolution and absorption rate of certain drugs is by formation of in situ salt formation, and that is increasing in pH of microenvironment of drug by incorporating buffer agent. But sometimes more soluble salt form of drug may result in poor absorption. And one such example is the salt of phenobarbital and barbital. The tablet of salt of phenobarbital swelled and it did not get disintegrate, hence dissolves slowly and results in poor absorption. And the next factor is drug pKa and gastrointestinal pH. Partition theory states that for drug compounds of molecular weight more than 100, which are primarily transported across the biomembrane by passive diffusion, absorption process is governed by the dissociation constant of the drug, which is denoted by pKa, the lipid solubility of the unionized drug, and the pH at the absorption site. The amount of drug that exists in unionized form and in ionized form is a function of pKa of drug, and pH of the fluid at the absorption site, and it can be determined by Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. For acidic drugs, the pH equal to pKa plus log the concentration of ionized form divided by the concentration of unionized form. And similarly, for basic drug, pH equal to pKa plus the concentration of unionized form divided by the concentration of ionized form. Very weak acids are essentially ionized at all pH values, and therefore their absorption is rapid and independent of gastrointestinal pH. Example of such drugs are phenytoin, ethosuximide, and several barbiturates. In the other hand, very weak bases are essentially ionized at all pH values, and therefore their absorption is rapid and dependent of pH. Caffeine, theophylline, and benzodiazepine are such drugs. As already mentioned, it is the pKa of the drug that determines the degree of ionization at a particular pH, and that only the unionized drug. So, if the drug is sufficiently lipid soluble, it is absorbed into the systemic circulation. So, even if the drug exists in the unionized form, it will be poorly absorbed if it has low lipid solubility. A lipid solubility is denoted by KO by W equal to distribution of drug in organic phase by distribution of drug in aqueous phase. The lipid solubility, that is the partition coefficient, increases, percentage of drug absorbed increases. The next factor is drug stability. Two major stability problems resulting poor bioavailability: degradation of drug into inactive form and interaction with one or more different components either of the dosage form or those present in the gastrointestinal tract to form a complex that is poorly soluble. And the last factor is stereochemical nature of drug. As a majority of the drug is absorbed passively, they do not display stereoselectivity. Conversely, a demonstration of stereoselective absorption would be strong evidence that a drug is absorbed by a carrier-mediated process. So, that's all for today. Check out more of our videos. Feel free to ask any question about the video, and also you can suggest the topic for our next video. You can also support us. For details, check the description box below. Your support will encourage us for making such videos. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you in our next segment. Till then, keep your preparation on and stay tuned with EduFarm.